Welcome to the control system lab. Today is our first experiment, that is to study the performance characteristics of a DC motor angular position control system. This is our experiment, and the apparatus required are DC position control unit, CRO, connecting wires, butter paper. Also, we have the block diagram here that is given. This is the input. We have two inputs here. One is step input, another one is continuous input. This is the module we are going to study, DC position control. Why we are going to study DC position control? A major portion of any first course on automatic control system invariably revolves around the DC, around the study of DC position control systems. Experimental work in this area has, however, been confined to analog simulated systems. For example, through our linear system simulator or similar other units. The biggest advantage of this approach is the unlimited flexibility and near perfect operation of the simulated systems, leading to a close correlation between theoretical and experimental results. However, the student is denied the feel of a physical electromechanical device. The present unit has been designed with this objective in mind. Despite the constraints like friction, dead zone, non-linearity due to amplifier saturation and motor current limiting and low speed of response associated with any mechanical system, the student has been provided with enough opportunity for experimenting on a work system. The panel diagram here shows various built-in subsystems which are now described. This is our motor unit. Here we have the motor inbuilt in this, that is the PMMC DC motor. Angular position of the motor shaft is sensed by 360 degree, this is here, 360 degree rotation potentiometer attached with this. This is the potentiometer which is attached with this, here and here. A calibrated disc that is mounted here on the potentiometer indicates its angular position. Okay. In addition to this, we have the TECO generator that is attached here with the motor. TECO generator is attached with the motor shaft, which produces the voltage proportional to its speed, which is used for velocity feedback. Okay, that TECO generator is attached here with the motor. This is our motor unit. We have two inputs here. First one is angle command, that is continuous signal obtained through a 360 degree servo potentiometer. That is a potentiometer with a calibrated disc attached with this. Another input, that is step input, that is here, available through a toggle switch. This is the toggle switch. Automatic synchronization with waveform capture circuit is provided in this. So here we have two inputs. One is this continuous signal, and another one is step input. Then we have the forward gain. We can move it from 0 to 10. Here are dots, there is 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 10. Then we have the driver circuit. Then we have the TECO generator here. But in this experiment, we are not giving the feedback, the TECO generator feedback. So this first experiment will be open loop. If we will give the TECO, what TECO generator does, it produces the voltage proportional to its speed, which is used for the velocity feedback. So here we are putting this TECO generator on zero, so we are not giving the feedback here. So here TECO generator has no work in this experiment number one. So in experiment number one, we are going to use this forward gain driver up to this, so we are not giving the feedback. So let us observe on CRO what we are going to observe. So first we will give the step angle command, that is continuous input, that is here, by varying the potentiometer. Look, we will change the reference input here, continuous signal. Same change will occur here on this motor unit. Look, 90 degrees, here is also 90 degrees. There will be some difference, very small difference, input and out. Here it is 100, it is 100. It is 120, it is 120. We can also check this by putting this input voltage. We can check the voltage. How much is the voltage, proportional voltage on this? We are, look, this is 1.66, it displays 1.66. If we will change, increase, the voltage will also increase proportionally. So this is the input, this is the output. Okay, this in degrees here, it is in degrees, this is also in degrees, also the input, it is here, the voltage input and output voltage, we can check here, okay, fine. Now we will give the second input through the step input. We have to up this button, so the step input is given here. Also we will change the gain, forward gain, and we will see how the output will behave on this oscilloscope that is here. When we will give the step input, we have to push this button, so that we can capture the signal. Here the red signal will be displayed. It will be here up to 10 seconds, then it will go again to display, so we can see the signal here. Because it is the step input, so signal will be for a small time. So we have to capture the signal in these 10 seconds. So we will check how we will see the signal practically. Now we will give the step input practically. I will push the button up and change the mode, okay. Now I will see whether a signal has come on the oscilloscope or not. Here I have two probes that are connected with this oscilloscope, X and Y. This is the ground potential, this one, and XY mode. And now the signal will be displayed here. I haven't given any forward gain, so this is our output right now. You can check it. Now I will increase the gain. Here I will increase the gain, that is from 0 to 10. When I will increase, I have put gain on 0, 1, 2, 3. Again I will repeat the steps. I will give the step again, then push on this mode, and we will get the output waveform on gain 3, forward gain. This is, here you will see some underdamped signal. Again I will increase the gain so that I can see what will happen if I will increase gain. Step, I will increase gain up to 5. I will give again step input, again capture. Now I will see how much is the gain. Here you are seeing the gain. Now again I will increase the gain. Here. So by increasing the gain, forward gain, you can see the overshoots are increasing. Look how much is the, right now the gain is almost is 8, and overshoots are increasing. Is the forward gain. So this is the experiment for the open loop, and you can draw these traces which I have shown here on the trace paper. I can show the example. This is the trace paper, and you can draw the traces like here. This is for gain 2, this is for gain 4, this for gain 6, this for gain 8, and this is for gain 10. Here you can see the system is now become the oscillatory. I will give an example how system is becoming oscillatory. Look, if I will increase the motor gain up to 10, look, the system will become oscillatory, more oscillatory. You can check it. Also on the CRO, you can see how much the system has become oscillatory on gain 10. Okay, this is the experiment about the forward open loop system of the DC position. Next time we will see the closed loop system. Thank you.